Okay, so let's go on to NEET 3.2. In this, we are going to discuss questions of our chapter 3 of class 11. That is, periodicity in properties, periodic table and periodicity in properties. In this, you will see that in the past few years, there are only questions which have come from the trend type of questions. Ionization energies kaise increase karti hai, electron beam enthalpies kaise decrease karti hai, atomic size kaise increase karega, ya bond dissociation energies vagera kaise increase karegi. So that is the type of questions which we are going to discuss. Is wale chapter mein se aapko at least one question to aana hi hai. There might be two questions which can come, correlating it with S block and P block. Theek hai? So let's go on to the questions over here. First question hamara kya hai? The species argon, potassium and calcium contain the same number of electrons. In which order do their radii increase? Okay, this is the question to us. Now over here you know that whenever we are talking of isoelectronic species, in case of isoelectronic species, greater the charge, lesser is going to be the radius. So yahan pe humko trend diya hua hai calcium, potassium and argon. So agar aap A wali option dekhte ho, Ca2 positive, theek hai, aur uske baad K positive aur uske baad argon. Argon mein van der Waals forces of attraction honge because of the noble gases which are present, so it is going to have the largest number of radius. Ca ke upar 2 positive charge hai, so that is going to have the lowest number of radius. ठीक है, so इसका जो option correct option होगा, that is going to be A. Now let's go on to question number 2. क्या है question number 2? Which of the following orders of ionic radii is correctly represented? So correctly represented में आपको पता है कि जब हम ionic radii करते हैं, तो ionic radii में the size of the cation, that is smaller to the size of the respective atom and is smaller to the size of the anion. ठीक है, so ये रहता है हमारा trend. अब इसमें अगर आप options देखो, तो first वाला जो है option number A, उसमें H negative का size बड़ा दिया हुआ है, then H positive और इससे बड़ा size दिया हुआ है hydrogen का, so this is going to be the correct option. ठीक है, कि cation से बड़ा size होता है, आप देखो cation से बड़ा size होता है atom का भी और cation से बड़ा size होता है anion का भी, and they have given us like this only कि cation is the smallest, anion has a bigger size and so does the hydrogen also has the bigger size. So option A, that is going to be the correct option in question number 2. Let's go on to question number 3. What is question number 3? Which one of the following arrangements represents the correct order of least negative to most negative electron gain enthalpy of carbon, calcium, aluminium, fluorine and oxygen? Now when we are talking of electron gain enthalpy, you know that the electron gain enthalpy that keeps on becoming more negative, that will keep on becoming more negative as we are going from left to right, and it keeps on becoming less negative as we go down the group, right? So हमारे पास elements दिए हुए हैं, इसको हम arrange करते हैं periodic table में, इनकी placement कैसे होती है? We have calcium, which is in the S block. Then the second one which is given to us, that is carbon. Carbon that is going to come in the, this is group 2. ठीक है, फिर 13 में हमारे पास क्या आ जाता है? Aluminium, right? So aluminium is the second element over here. फिर उसके बाद group 14 में carbon आ गया, which is going to be the first element over here. And then group 15 का हमारे पास कोई भी यहाँ पे present नहीं है. We go to group 16. Group 16 का oxygen present है और group 17 का fluorine present है. तो आप पहले, rather than looking at the options, पहले आप एक rough सा idea अपना लिख लो कि वो क्या पूछ रहे हैं question में. Which one of the following arrangements represents the correct order of least negative to most negative electron gain enthalpy? So as we just seen that along this thing, more electron gain enthalpy जो है, that will keep on becoming more and more negative. So keeping that in mind, you will have the lowest electron gain enthalpy for calcium. फिर उसके बाद it will be for aluminium, then for carbon, and then for oxygen, and then for fluorine. So look at option D, calcium is less than aluminium, less than carbon, less than oxygen, less than fluorine. So option D, that is going to be the correct option. ठीक है? इस तरह से आपने ये questions करने होते हैं. Let's go on to question number 4. Question number 4 is, what is the value of electron gain enthalpy of sodium? If ionization energy of sodium is 5.1. Now electron gain enthalpy and ionization enthalpy, they should, for the same element, should have the same numerical value. It is only the sign which is going to be different. So if ionization energy positive aayegi, to electron gain enthalpy negative aayegi. So answer is mein negative ka kya diya hua hai? Option number A, which is minus 5.1 electron volt. Because the energy to extract and put the electron should be same for the same element. ठीक है? Only the signs, they should be different. Now let's go on to question number 5. What is question number 5? The correct order of decreasing ionic radii among the following isoelectronic species. Again, we will use the same formula. Greater the positive charge, lesser is going to be the radius. Larger the negative charge, larger is going to be the radius. So the species which are given to us, that is S2 negative, Cl negative, then they have given us K positive and Ca2 positive. So isme sabse chota size iska hona chahiye, usse bada size iska hona chahiye, usse bada size chloride ka hona chahiye aur sabse bada size sulfide ka hona chahiye. So option C over here, that is going to be the correct option. Is it clear? Then let's go to question number 6. What is our question number 6? Question number 6 says, which of the following represents the correct order of increasing electron gain enthalpy with negative sign for the element oxygen, sulfur, fluorine and chlorine? तो इसको हम प्लेस करके देखते हैं. We have oxygen, sulfur, fluorine and chlorine. We know that the electron gain enthalpies should become less and less negative. But यहाँ पे fluorine और oxygen, they have anomalously low value of electron gain enthalpy because of small size electron electronic repulsions which are going to take place. तो यहाँ पे क्या होगा? आपको पता है कि fluorine की जो electron gain enthalpy है, that is less than fluorine. उसी तरह से ऑक्सीजन की इलेक्ट्रॉन गेन एंथैल्पी, दैट इज गोइंग टू बी लेस देन क्लोरीन. सो व्हाट इज गोइंग टू बी द ट्रेंड? यहाँ पे अगर हम सबसे छोटे से करें तो ऑक्सीजन की सबसे कम होनी चाहिए, फिर उसके बाद सल्फर की होनी चाहिए, फिर उसके बाद क्लोरीन की होनी चाहिए और फिर उसके बाद क्लोरीन की होनी चाहिए. ऐसे क्वेश्चन आप खुद से सॉल्व करके फिर ऑप्शन के साथ उनको कंपेयर करोगे तो आपके लिए ईजी होगा. अगर आप पहले ऑप्शन देखोगे तो यू ऑलवेज हैव अ टेंडेंसी टू गेट कंफ्यूज. ठीक है, सो लेट्स सी व्हिच ऑफ दीस आर गोइंग टू व्हिच ट्रेंड इज गोइंग टू बी फॉलोड. ए इज नॉट, सो बी इज द करेक्ट ऑप्शन. ठीक है, ऑक्सीजन इज लेस देन सल्फर, लेस देन फ्लोरीन, लेस देन क्लोरीन, सो बी इज गोइंग टू बी द करेक्ट ऑप्शन. क्लियर हो गया? तो लेट्स गो ऑन टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 7. What is question number 7? Among the elements calcium, magnesium, phosphorus and chlorine, the order of increasing atomic radii. Again, isko aap place karo pehle, hamare paas hai calcium, magnesium, phosphorus and chlorine. So magnesium aapka aata hai pehle, phir aayega calcium. Theek hai, aur phir uske baad next humko kaun sa diya hua hai? They have given us phosphorus. Phosphorus belongs to the 15th group. ठीक है, एंड देन दे हैव गिवन अस क्लोरीन. राइट, क्लोरीन बिलोंग्स टू द 17th ग्रुप. तो क्या बोल रहे हैं? ऑर्डर ऑफ इंक्रीजिंग एटॉमिक रेडियस, तो सबसे छोटा अलोंग अ पीरियड व्हेन वी आर मूविंग द एटॉमिक रेडियस, दैट इज डिक्रीजिंग. सो क्लोरीन का साइज सबसे छोटा, उसके बाद फास्फोरस का, उसके बाद मैग्नीशियम का, और जब हम डाउन द ग्रुप जाते हैं तो इन दैट केस एटॉमिक रेडियस दैट इज गोइंग टू इंक्रीज. तो इससे बड़ा कौन सा होना चाहिए? कैल्शियम. So if you're looking at the trend, I think B is going to be the correct option. ठीक है, chlorine, phosphorus, magnesium and calcium. Have you understood? Then let's go on to the next question. following electronic configurations, which one of them may have the highest ionization energy? Now over here, if you're looking at option A, neon 3s2 3p2, this is the first option given to us, neon 3s2 3p2, okay? Second option jo hume diya hai, that is argon 3d10 4s2 4p3. Now this is half filled, okay? So half filled ki ionization energy zyada hoti hai. So B option ki energy zyada hogi A option se. Phir uske baad hamare paas neon aa gaya, neon is 3s2 3p1, only one electron, so iski ionization energy should be less. Then we come to D option, neon 3s2 3p3. Now in this case also it is half filled. So now if you are comparing option B and option D, option B may the electron has to be removed from the fourth shell. The ionization energy jo hai wo kam chahiye. Or D may humko remove karna from the third shell. So ionization energy is going to be highest in option B. Theek hai? Half filled or it has to be removed from the third. Right? So option D is going to be the correct option. Ninth question kya hai? Which one of the following arrangements does not give the correct picture of trends indicated against against it? Theek hai? So yahan pe hamare paas kya aa gaya? Order of bond energy diya hua hai F2, Cl2, Br2, I2, which is wrong. Right? Jabki order of bond dissociation energy hoti kya hai? Cl2 ki sabse zyada, phir bromine ki, phir F2 ki aur phir I2 ki. The reason behind fluorine having low value of ionization of bond dissociation energy is the inter-electronic repulsions due to small size. Theek hai? So A is wrong. And similarly when you go to D, D is also going to be wrong. Electron gain enthalpy bhi jo hai wo wrong hai, kyunki chlorine ki electron gain enthalpy is going to be higher than fluorine. So these kind of questions are sometimes bonus questions also. Ispe agar aap A tick karoge then also it is right, aur agar aap D tick karoge then also it is right. Theek hai? Clear ho gaya? Then let's go on to question number 10. What is question number 10? With which of the following electronic configuration and the atom has the lowest ionization energy? Periodic table mein aapko pata hai ki lowest ionization energy alkali metals ki hoti hai with the electronic configuration of NS1. So you have to see which has NS1 electronic configuration. It is B which has the NS1, 1s2, 2s2, 2p5, 3s1. So lowest ionization energy, that is going to be of B. Got it? Then let's go on to question number 11. What is question number 11? Ionic radii are inversely proportional to effective nuclear charge, inversely proportional to square of effective nuclear charge, directly proportional to effective nuclear charge, directly proportional to square of effective nuclear charge. Obviously, you know that when the effective nuclear charge that is going to increase, it is going to attract the outermost shell more towards itself. Agar wo zyada attract karega to size ko kya hona chahiye? It should decrease. So hamare paas aata hai ki radii, that is inversely proportional to effective nuclear charge. That is the reason why jo cation ka size hota hai wo atom se kam hota hai ya chota hota hai aur anion ka size jo hai wo bada hota hai. Theek hai? So yahan pe radii, that is going to be inversely proportional to effective nuclear charge. So option A, that is going to be the correct option. Okay, then let's go on to question number 13. Sorry, question number 12. So what is our question number 12? Which statement is wrong? Bond dissociation energy of F2 is greater than Cl2. This is wrong. Bond dissociation energy of chlorine is greater than F2. Theek hai? Electronegativity of fluorine is greater than Cl. Correct. F is more oxidizing than Cl. Correct. Fluorine, that is at the top of the electrochemical series. Theek hai? And D, electron affinity of chlorine is greater than fluorine. This is also correct. right? So what, which is the wrong statement over here? Option A, that is going to be wrong. Okay, then let's go on to question number 13. Question number 13 kya hai? The first ionization potential electron hold of beryllium and boron respectively. Pooch rahe ho. Ab aapko pata hai ki when we looking at the electronic configuration of boron and beryllium, iski electronic configuration hoti hai NS2NB1. ठीक है और इसकी इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फ़िगरेशन होती है NS2NB2 सो द आयनाइजेशन एनर्जी फॉर बेरिलियम शुड बी हायर देन दैट ऑफ बोरोन सो लेट्स लुक एट द ऑप्शंस ओवर हियर ए में बोरोन की एनर्जी दी है 8.29 और बी की बेरिलियम की भी दी है सॉरी बेरिलियम की 8.29 और बोरोन की भी 8.29 बोथ कैन नॉट हैव सेम सो ए इज द रॉन्ग ऑप्शन ठीक है बी हमें दी है 9.32 रॉन्ग C हमें दिया 8.29 9.32 अब बेरिलियम की ज्यादा होनी चाहिए सो इसलिए ऑप्शन डी इज गोइंग टू बी द करेक्ट ऑप्शन जिसमें बेरिलियम की हमें 9.32 दी हुई है और बोरोन की 8.29 इट इज नॉट दिस केस में आपको सबकी आयनाइजेशन एनर्जी जो है उनको लर्न करने की जरूरत है यू जस्ट नीड टू नो बेस्ड ऑन इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फ़िगरेशन किसकी ज्यादा होनी चाहिए और किसकी कम होनी चाहिए तो उसके बेसिस पे आपने इस क्वेश्चन को अटेम्प्ट करना है ठीक है द लास्ट क्वेश्चन व्हिच वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस क्वेश्चन नंबर 14 क्या है इन द पीरियोडिक टेबल विद द इंक्रीज इन एटॉमिक नंबर द मेटालिक कैरेक्टर ऑफ एन एलिमेंट को क्या होता है यू नो दैट द मेटालिक कैरेक्टर इन द पीरियोडिक टेबल जैसे जैसे हम डाउन द ग्रुप जाते हैं वैसे वैसे आयनाइजेशन एनर्जी जो है दैट इज गोइंग टू डिक्रीज एंड द मेटालिक कैरेक्टर विल इंक्रीज Because the ionization energy that is inversely proportional to metallic character. And as we are moving along a period, the ionization energy increases. Therefore, the metallic character that is going to decrease. So, what is going to be the correct option over here? It decreases in a period and increases in a group. So, option A, that is going to be the correct option. So, these are the kind of questions which have come in the previous years. So, we finished with our chapter 3, NEET 3.2. We will start with the fourth chapter in our next class. Okay?